An equilibrium of a dynamical system is a constant solution. That means, if the initial condition is equal to the equilibrium, we will stay at that value forever. Plugging the equilibrium into the dynamical system gives the same number back for the next time step. How do we find such a constant solution? Let's work it out with an example. Let x sub t plus 1 equal 4 plus 0.6 times x sub t. We can check if 2 is in equilibrium by plugging x sub t equals 2 into the system to see if we get 2 back. We calculate that x sub t plus 1 equals 5.2. Since 5.2 is not the same number as 2, the value changed and 2 is not in equilibrium. Now, we could go ahead and try plugging in lots of different numbers and hope that eventually we find the value of the equilibrium. But there are a lot of numbers out there, and it might take a long time until we find the right one. And even if we found one equilibrium, how do we know if that is the only one? Maybe the dynamical system has two equilibria, or even more equilibria. We can let variables come to the rescue. Since a variable can stand for any number, we can try all numbers at once with a variable. Let's use the variable capital E for the equilibrium. If we plug in x sub t equals e into the dynamical system, we can see if we get e back out for x sub t plus 1. For our example, plugging in e for x sub t gives x sub t plus 1 equals 4 plus 0.6 times e. For e to be in equilibrium, we need the value of x sub t plus 1 to be e. In other words, we need 4 plus 0.6e to be equal to e. If we can find a number e for which e equals 4 plus 0.6 times e, then e is in equilibrium. Let's solve this equation for e. By subtracting off 0.6e from both sides of the equation, we get the condition 0.4e equals 4. Dividing both sides by 0.4, we get the final answer that e equals 10. We have found that x sub t equals 10 is in equilibrium of the dynamical system x sub t plus 1 equals 4 plus 0.6 x sub t. In fact, since 10 is the only value of e where 4 plus 0.6 times e equals e, we can see that we have found all equilibria. The solution, x sub t equals 10, is the only equilibrium of the dynamical system. Let's try this again for a couple more examples. Example 2 is y sub n plus 1 minus y sub n equals 1. We try to find an equilibrium, y sub n equals e, by plugging in e for both y sub n and y sub n plus 1. E is in equilibrium if e minus e equals 1, or 0 equals 1. The equation for the equilibrium has no solutions. The dynamical system has no equilibria. That makes sense. We are adding the number 1 at each time step, so there's no way to have a constant solution. Example 3 is z sub t plus 1 minus z sub t equals z sub t squared minus z sub t. We set both z sub t and z sub t plus 1 equal to e to look for the equilibria. We find the equation 0 equals e squared minus e. To solve this equation, we factor, obtaining 0 equals e times the quantity e minus 1. One of the two factors must be 0, so either e equals 0 or e minus 1 equals 0. The equilibria are e equals 0 and e equals 1. Both z sub t equals 0 and z sub t equals 1 are constant solutions to the dynamical system. To verify that both 0 and 1 are equilibria, you can plug in those numbers to see that z doesn't change. In summary, to calculate the equilibria of a discrete dynamical system, replace all occurrences of the state variable with the variable e, then solve the resulting equation for E.